Jersey's biggest hits.
2 years ago this week, one of the biggest hits in the USA was All I Want by a band that worked for peanuts. Literally. I'll have details in that big hit after this.
American Top 40.
Headed number 34 is the other new act debuting this week. This one has an even stranger name. Toad the Wet Sprocket. With their song called All I Want.
Nothing so loud.
Casey's Top 40.
I'm Casey Kasem. Casey's Top 40 originates in Hollywood. Well, now we're up to the first hit for a band with one of the oddest names ever in rock and roll. The Beatles found the inspiration for their name in the name of Buddy Holly's group, the Crickets. More recently, the B-52s got their name from a bouffant hairstyle. But few band names in rock and roll are as strange or as silly as Toad the Wet Sprocket. That name has nothing to do with amphibious animals or drenched bicycle parts. Instead, Toad the Wet Sprocket was first mentioned in a routine by the wacky British comedy group Monty Python's Flying Circus. It was part of a satire on rock journalism. And it sounded like this.
Rex Stardust, lead Electric Triangle with Toad the Wet Sprocket, has had to have an elbow removed following their recent successful worldwide tour of Finland. Flamboyant, ambidextrous.
Eric Idle of Monty Python's Flying Circus with the world's first mention of a fictitious rock band named Toad the Wet Sprocket. Well, years ago, when a Santa Barbara, California musician named Dean Dinning heard that routine, he couldn't stop laughing. And he decided right then and there that if he ever got a group together, he'd name it Toad the Wet Sprocket. Dean even drew a logo for his future band, a frog jumping out of a wet sprocket. Well, in time, Dean Dinning did put a band together, and he proposed his favorite name. At first, the other members objected, but Dean insisted. So they said they'd use it temporarily, only until they thought of something better. That was back in 1986. And try as they might, they've never been able to improve on Toad the Wet Sprocket. This week, that name graces the song that climbs three notches to number 13 on Casey's Top 40.
Here's that band who made their first album for only $650. That was the total cost for Toad the Wet Sprocket. Now, the Toads got together here in California in their hometown, Santa Barbara, back in 1986. They were four friends in school, they were bored, and they thought it just might be fun to form a band. So they went through a few different names. Names like Three Young Studs and Glen. That was a good one. And that was all before they changed their name to Toad the Wet Sprocket. And that was inspired by a Monty Python skit. Now, just around that time, they started playing at a funky local club called The Shack. And they became pretty popular. Eventually, they settled in as the house band. And then a local singer asked them to back him in a recording session in exchange for studio time for them. They cut two songs and decided to spend $650 to record more songs and put out their own album that they would call Pale. And suddenly there was a big buzz, as they say in the biz, and the band was signed to Columbia Records, and Columbia put out that album as is. The band then spent $5,000 for a second album called Bread and Circus, and their third album is reported to have cost in the six figures range. But proving that you get what you pay for, because now Toad the Wet Sprocket have their first top 40 hit at number 15, All I Want. What does the word fear mean to you? Shivers down the spine? Tingling nerves? Bones chilled? Fear is the title of the latest album by Toad the Wet Sprocket, and one of the Toads, Glen Phillips, told us, "It comes out of a period of change. The past 2 years, we were suddenly without a routine in our lives. Before, we always had routines, jobs and school, which gave us clear degrees of moving forward, and now without that, there's a lot of fear about facing change and the responsibilities that come with it." So smiling through clenched teeth at number 13, here's Toad the Wet Sprocket. With all the latest in music and more than 50 years of Billboard hit facts and figures, this is American Top 40. I'm Shadoe Stevens. Check out this little bit of chart history. It's really wild. During some downtime over at the AT40 Tribological Research Center, they were doing some filing, and they noticed that one of the guys in Toad the Wet Sprocket, the bass player, is named Dean Dinning. So, of course, they wondered. After all, it's their job to wonder, and they wondered, could he be related to a bunch of other Dinnings who hit the chart a long time ago? Well, wouldn't you know it, it's true. Dean Dinning had three aunts and one uncle who all hit the top 40. Dean's aunts, Ginger Lou and Jean, were from Chicago, and they sang together as the Dinning Sisters, and their only big hit was a top 10 version of an old song called Buttons and Bows, way back in 1948. And then the sisters' kid brother, Dean's uncle, also hit the top 40. In fact, 33 years ago this week, Uncle Mark Dinning had a number one song across the USA called Teen Angel. The latest Dinning to hit the charts is at number 10 this week. Here's Dean Dinning and the rest of Toad the Wet Sprocket with Walk on the Ocean.
Number 36.
Falling 8 Notches are four musicians who've been together since their high school days, 7 years ago. Here's Toad the Wet Sprocket and Walk on the Ocean.
We spotted the ocean. American Top 40.
Leading the chart charge to number one, I'm Shadoe Stevens, American Top 40. Next, it's Toad the Wet Sprocket, and the first hit off their new album, Dulcinea. Now, I mentioned before that the title comes from the story of Don Quixote, a book written by the Spanish author Cervantes almost 500 years ago at the start of the 1600s. In the 1960s, it found renewed interest in the musical The Man of La Mancha. Now, in the story, Don Quixote is an old man who thinks that he's a knight. He's on a quest for truth and justice and even love. He thinks that a barmaid in tattered clothes named Aldonza is his magical love of perfection and beauty, Dulcinea. He even sings a song about her. Now that's where Toad the Wet Sprocket got Dulcinea for the title for their latest album. Bass player Dean Denning told us, "She represents an ideal of perfection that does not exist, but we keep trying to reach that ideal, and that's when the music happens." And singer-lyricist Glen Phillips says, "Instead of loving things for what they are, you love them for what you wish they were. That can drive you to do great deeds, or at least what you perceive as great deeds." So with all that in mind, you might say that just like Don Quixote, Toad the Wet Sprocket are on a quest of their own here at American Top 40, attacking the windmill at number 25 this week is Fall Down.
She said, "I'm fine, I hope you cover up your trembling hands."
Casey's biggest hit.
2 years ago this week, one of the biggest hits in the USA was by a band that worked for peanuts. Literally. It sounds like a joke, but the members of Toad the Wet Sprocket swear it's actually true. Back in 1986, they couldn't find anyone who'd hire them to play. So they approached the owner of a popular Los Angeles beach bar called The Shack and told him if he gave them a chance, they'd play for free. He told him he didn't really feel good about that, so they could have all the peanuts they wanted. Of course, so could any of the customers. The peanuts were stored in big barrels around the room where anyone could take all they wanted. But it was a start. A start that led to one of the biggest hits in the USA 2 years ago this week. Here's Toad the Wet Sprocket with All I Want.
Casey's Top 40.
I'm Casey Kasem, counting down the top 100 hits of the year. And rolling in at number 71 is Toad the Wet Sprocket. They're good friends with fellow golf fanatics Hootie and the Blowfish. And both bands made this year's year-end survey with songs from the soundtrack to the TV sitcom Friends. At number 79, we heard Hootie and the Blowfish with I Go Blind. Now here's Toad the Wet Sprocket with Good Intentions.
It's hard to rely on good intentions.
Casey's Top